find it. Watch me. Jenna, watch me. Start with your hands on the side of the hips. And then slowly roll your hands in until you feel the pointy bone underneath your hand. Then go to it. Okay, everybody, find your own. Sometimes we call them the headlights, right? Right there. Feel it? Feel that lump on the front? That is on the front of your pelvis. So it's anterior. It's the most superior bump on your ilium bone. Therefore, it's superior. It's pointy. So it's a spine. It's on the ilium bone, so it's iliac. So it's the A-S-I-S, as is. Everybody find that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, if you hook your fingers around that bump to the soft, tender underbelly of yourselves and push out into the bone, there's the point for L1. Everybody find it?
Oh.
It might be sensitive. Okay, that's L1. So, on N. This one is, so on Anne's right side, there's more tension in the tissue. Now, when I'm checking this point, I just want to point out that I'm not pushing down towards the table. I'm pushing, like if this is her ASIS sticking up, we'll pretend my thumb is it. The point is here.
Mm-hmm.
It's on the medial margin of the ASIS, and it's on the bone, on the inside of this lip right there. That's an L. Okay, that's the L1 point. All right, let's make a cave. So in order to make a cave around this point, the first thing I'm going to do is ask you to bend your knees up. Great. I'm going to cross your ankle towards me, and I'm going to get a hold of the sole of your foot. So that allows me to bring the legs up, flop them towards me. There we go. And she's supported. See that?
Mm-hmm.
Is it still sore?
That
looks no. So this position zeroes out the tension and the sensitivity at that point. Okay? Now, I could do this to compress down the legs, but actually the weight of her legs is providing compression, so I can just hang out here and wait for it to pulse.
Could you do it with one leg?
No.
No? Okay.
Because I want you to notice that what this position is doing at the L1 area of her spine, you see how this part of her spine is getting a little kink? Little tiny baby cave. If I did it with one leg, I wouldn't be engaging the pelvis in the same way.
Okay.
So we need both legs for this. Is pulsing away happily, joyfully?
Yeah.
They're holding hands and singing songs. Let's take it down. Okay. And integration. What did I just work with? L1. So let's integrate where L1 is. You might be tempted to rock the hips, but L1's up here. Okay. And now let's just recheck and see if anything has changed. Any nicer?
A lot softer.
Yeah, it's a lot softer. So we just released L1.
Wow.
Okay. The point for L2, you're going to find the ASIS, and then you're going to find your pubic bone, which is right in front, the side of your pubic bone. You're going to draw a line between the two, and in the middle, that's where the L2 point is, midway between the side of the pubic bone and the ASIS, in the center, and you'll have one on both sides. Okay. Now, if anybody's shy about finding the pubic bone, here's how you do it. You go in through the side. I remember when I first learned this, I went, what if I touch a penis? I would be so embarrassed, and my client would be so uncomfortable. If you go in from the side this way, there's the side of the pubic bone. Believe me, the family jewels are not going to be lying over here or over there. So you just go in through the side, and you won't get a penis, okay? Come on, how many of you were worried about that, really? Right? Okay. So you go into this side, you find the side of the pubic bone. If you're not comfortable, ask the client, would you please touch the side of your pubic bone? If they don't know where that is, could you touch the side of your pubic bone? And the, oh, there? Okay, sure, it's right there. They'll show you. So the side of her pubic bone, her ASIS. She's a tiny woman, tiny frame, so the distance isn't very far, so it's going to be right there. Hello. That's a good one. Or over here.
Yeah, sore too.
Well, which one is more sore?
More alliteration.
This one?
Yeah.
Left side. So her left side is more sore. So we're going to make a cave around that. I'm going to go to the same side as the point I want to treat.
I'm really working.
Okay, here I am. Okay, so here's our point. And it's generally either on, above, or just below the inguinal ligament. There's a big ligament there. So again, if you'll bend your knees up. Great. I'm going to cross the ankle towards me, take a hold underneath the bottom foot, and then bring the legs up, support them on my body. This looks very much like the other one, but it's the position is subtly different because I'm softening a different point. The, you know, if I was trying to soften her belly button area, I'd bring the legs way up here, right? But we're more down here. So I'm going to just check. Is it less sensitive?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I know I have the right position. So I'm going to hang out and wait for an indicator. It's pulsing already.
Mm-hmm.
It's really pulsing. It's got a 6-piece band in there going to town.
I could see that people would love this.
And notice, again, very subtle kinking of the spine at the level of L2 from this position.
Classified as abdominal work?
No.
Okay.
I'm working on the lumbar spine.
Okay.
Even though I'm on the front of her body, I'm working with the lumbar spine.
Okay.
Alrighty. So, has it changed?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Now, sometimes people get confused about, how did you cross those feet? Easy way to remember. If I forget and I do it the wrong way, let's say I cross her ankle away from me, right? And then I go to pick it up. I've only got one leg. Okay? So I cross the ankle towards me, and then I've got control of both legs. Okay?
So do you start with the one that's more sore? Do you really spoke to them?
No,
you
don't, because how many L2s do we have in our body?
Just one.
So the point that's the most sensitive will release the totality of the oneness of the L2. You don't need to do both sides. One side is sufficient. Okay? And these are Janet Trevell's points for the lumbar spine that we're using here. Giving credit where credit's due. So if you know Janet Trevell's work and you look up her lumbar points, this is what you'll find. L1 and L2, the points are on the anterior body, and 3, 4, and 5 are on the posterior body. Okay?
So a comment, a question about that. Do more of her points coincide? Do a lot of the, like the cave or the access point,
I have no
coincide
idea.
With her trigger point?
I really don't patterns? Know because the only Trevell points I know are the ones I've learned through orthomyotomy.
Okay.
And I didn't even know that they were Trevell points when I learned it. It was many years later I went, oh, those are Trevell's points.
Mm-hmm.
Not that it matters.
Yeah.
In orthobionomy, anything that's sensitive can be caved.
Okay.
It just so happens that this is a point that corresponds to L1 and a point that corresponds to L2.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, any questions about that?